Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.
Hi guys, welcome to Film Companion. Welcome to my show on the channel. It's called Spill the Tea. And I've managed to get all you wonderful actors together only because of your film, Rajesh, Loot Case, which is releasing on the 31st of July. Let's put that plug in right at the start of the show.
Yay! Thank you so much.
Are you having fun promoting a film from the comfort of your home? What's that been like?
It is interesting, you know. It's actually I don't know if we can. I think maybe we'll also stick around with this idea later on when, you know, things get better, because it's so easy to like be accessible to everybody throughout the country. It saves a lot of cost also, I think we can also do the environment a favor by like not driving in multiple cars and multiple equipment and, you know, so many things that go in. All kind of using the lights that we have and going through this. So, we still miss out on the fact that, you know, you're sitting next to each other. Also, you have the option of turning your, you know, just taking, making it mute, or like turning your camera off if you do not agree.
We have the option of not wearing our pants.
That is true. I am wearing a shirt with shorts.
Hey, Mio.
Hey, Mira. Sneha, Mira.
Mira, nine.
Kya karna hai?
Nine.
Kya?
Don't get up. Gajraj sir, don't get up. Don't.
Rani, are you get up?
Don't get up. No, Gajraj sir, no.
तो मेरा सपना था बहुत बचपन का, जब मैंने राकेश शर्मा को देखा था ना, जब वो स्पेस में गए थे और वहां से उन्होंने इंदिरा गांधी से बात किया था, तो मेरा ऐसा कहीं था मेरे दिमाग में कि ऐसा मैं कब करूंगा कि मैं ऐसा डिजिटली किसी से बात करूंगा, इंटरव्यू दूंगा. तो ये जो डिजिटल इंटरव्यू का जो मेरा वो सपना पूरा हुआ है इस पूरे प्रोसेस में, ऐसा लग रहा है.
See, I mean, whatever the actually there are, you know, these guys are right. You switching off the camera, unmuting, wearing shorts and chaddis, all this, you know, is sounds great. But actually, to be honest with you, now 4 months into this lockdown, and you know, I'm just tired of it. I don't want to do any Zoom parties. I don't want to do any Zoom meetings. I want to physically go and I used to hate marketing and media. You know, when a release happens, I'm not very fond of, because you know you constantly have to talk about the same things and it gets tiring. So I've never really enjoyed it, but now I would give my left arm to go back to the old form of just having to go somewhere, you know, go to a radio station, go to a publication and talk about your film, and just I miss that now.
I mean, I was never keen on going out for groceries, but now I'm like that dog that starts wagging the tail the moment somebody goes away.
Wow. You know, I'm always so envious of someone who has such incredible comic timing. Just like I can see all of you do, you're a complete riot, at least on screen. I'm curious to know, are you fundamentally funny folk, or have you figured out the science to getting comedy right?
No, I think comedy has always been a natural, how do I put it?
Oh, I remember seeing this guy being a Vijay. When this guy was family.
I was definitely funny before I was an actor. So for sure.
I remember seeing him. I used to be in Channel V at that time. I would remember this guy was actually funnier when he was off air. And then I keep asking, why don't we unleash this guy on there? No, dude, we can't, because this it'll end up causing I don't know what kind of controversies. So, there you go.
But Kunal, is there a science to comedy that you've cracked over time? Because your best performances have been the funny ones. Like, people really take to you there.
I don't know if there is a science. I think it's a lot about timing. And some of
instinct,
it you have and some of it you work with. And I think it also, comedy kind of gets better or worse with the kind of, because it's an action-reaction relationship. If the reaction is not right, and by that I mean an actor, firstly. And then because this is for screen, it's equally important to have the right director and the right editor who knows how to edit comedy. Where do you land a joke? On whose face? How do you shoot it? So yes, in terms of cinema, it is more of a teamwork of that timing. Whereas on stage, you just need that correct actor to jam with, to make a joke work or to make a situation work. But beyond that, I don't think there is so much of a science. It's like you either have it or you don't, because with comedy, there is no mid ground. You can make somebody laugh or you just can't make them laugh. It's not like, but I made you smile, but that's not good enough.
Yeah.
Like that.
But you know, I mean this as the biggest possible compliment, Gajraj sir, but when I see your face, I automatically crack up because I'm instantly taken back to all those movie memories that you contributed to. I'm curious to know, is there an actor that does this for each of you? Like you just look at them and you're laughing.
Yeah.
I think Gajraj sir has the same effect on me, but not laughing, but he makes me like, I feel like, okay, things are going to be better now that he's around.
Yes. It's a very positive kind
of. Yeah. Like, I feel like, okay, now he's here, now something will be better, easier. Things will just be easier.
Who's it for you, Rasika?
Sumit Vyas. You know, I can't even act in a scene with Sumit because I'm only laughing looking at his face. And Sumit has this way of giggling through many things. And I'm very fond of people who giggle because that's what I do most of the time. Sumit will just come into a scene. And Sumit has done this in the middle of a stage performance, a live performance. He started laughing and walked off stage also. So I think every time he comes in front of me, I can't stop laughing. It's very hard to work with him.
I think people who are funny have this inherent faith in the intelligence of humanity. They believe that if I throw something which is basically a read between the lines kind of a thing, there are people out there in the universe who will catch it in the exact way it was decoded, the exact way it was encoded.
Unless you've thrown something really stinky, then they will not. And then you will be left like this.
Sorry, Sneha, I wanted to just say that because we've had such iconic comic actors that they have sometimes become bigger than the so-called leading man or a star in a film, and sometimes film were devised around them, like for example Mehmood Saab or Johnny Lever. Yeah. I remember in theaters, before Johnny Lever has said anything, there is just laughter because he's just come in and he's made a face and everybody's just laughing. So I mean, I think you earn that. That is something that you earn with your work. And that's why we've had legendary actors like Jagdeep Saab. He just recently passed away. And he's one of those faces. Yeah. And when you see him, it just, you're in anticipation of something good or something funny is going to happen. So, yeah, I mean, it's great to be in that position. And of course, Gajraj sir is one of those actors who's had that effect already. Like, you see that the slight nuance and you're like, you're going to laugh.
Yeah, mujhe itni tarife ek saath sunne ki aadat nahi hai. एकदम घबराहट सी हो जाती है.
It's just not letting him speak.
What do you have to say about this, Gajraj sir?
Who does this for you, Gajraj sir?
Yes.
Sorry. तो बहुत सारे faces हैं जो कि मुझे एकदम से, हाँ, मुझे जैसे रणवीर ने बोला कि वो आपको एक 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 दूसरी दुनिया में ले जाते हैं.
Positive vibe.
जॉनी वॉकर साहब, विनय पाठक, एक बंगाली एक्टर है रॉबी घोष, तो सत्यजीत रे की सिनेमा में बहुत आए, गोपी गायन, बागा बायन, उत्पल दत्त, वुडी एलन, ये जो क्लूजो जो एक्टर करते हैं, क्या नाम,
पीटर सेलर्स.
तो वो देखोगे तो आपको लगेगा कि उनकी कुछ सीरियस फिल्में देखी मैंने ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट पहले की. तो मैं पूरा अभी पीछे देखी मैंने, तो मैं पूरे समय वेट करता रहा अभी स्माइल करना, अभी कुछ होगा, वो होता नहीं, लेकिन उनके फेस में एक इतनी पॉजिटिविटी है, तो यस, ये फर्क पड़ता है.
And speaking of the film, I was going through some of the comments on the YouTube trailer, and the sentiment largely seemed to voice something along the lines of self-made underrated actors finally need to get their due. I know it's still early days, but do you feel like the tide is changing with the conversations that you've been having in the recent past?
It's too early to say if the tide is changing. We've just noticed the fact that there is a tide. We just have to see how long these conversations keep alive and if there is actually a ripple effect, so to say, of what is being said right now, and more so very aggressively at times on social media. But we haven't seen the effect yet. I think what is great is that this is a time when people are talking about it, they're discussing it, they're debating about it. But the idea is to keep that alive and not just give it a fake, take it into a zone where it becomes, where it leads to animosity in any way, because then we're not going to reach anywhere. Because if we start...
Or be a flavor of the month kind of a conversation.
Yeah, also, I think it has to be constructive more than saying that, because I keep saying that it's not a hero-villain debate. It's not like if this one person is removed from the equation is going to change. It's a team that is working. The team just needs to modify its workings.
I just feel that, I mean, there will be a marginal change at least, but that has nothing to do with, you know, your like you said, YouTube comments or Twitter hashtags. I think what will change, what will make things a little better will be the arrival of streaming platforms. Because I think that will work as a, you can say, as a safety valve, like in a pressure cooker, when because the theatrical system, you know, there's so much pressure for those particular shows, particular theaters, and you have so many bigger players who, you know, who are more in command. The streaming platforms will work, I think, as a safety valve, where at least the storytellers and filmmakers, you know, artists, technicians who couldn't reach the audience because of the flaws in the theatrical system, will at least have some way to reach their audience. So I think more than YouTube, YouTube comment sections and Twitter hashtags, it will be the arrival of streaming platforms that will make some difference.
It has for the last 2 years, and I think I've felt the effect of it personally in my career the most. And streaming platforms, like Ranveer said, has given me an opportunity to access different sorts of work and also access a wider audience, which I have really been grateful for. And I think that that's an example of how the business sort of introduced something which is fairly democratic and still remains that way, you know. So even if you had new players in the game two years back, which was very exciting for everybody, even in terms of writers, directors, actors, and so there are new people who are joining the business, and there's a lot of newness in terms of content and the way that they think, and also the people who are sort of ruling the roost or successful, so to say, at that point are also sort of prompted to or incentivized to up their game or change it around, as because it's creating an environment which is competitive and healthy. So yeah, I think that's happened. I hope it remains like that. I've enjoyed it over the last 2 years. Let's see what it has got to offer in the years to come. But yeah.
Gajraj sir?
I presuppose this question is not for me because I'm not yet rated.
No. But you are well versed with the ways of the web. So you must have seen how it's opened it up for actors.
Yeah, for sure. But I've just done one web series though. I mean, it's like a one season is what I did.
Yeah.
But I was more to know if I really know how to speak in that language at all.
Correct.
But please, Gajraj.
I'm just trying to understand whether you feel the conversation is changing now when it comes to putting the spotlight on self-made, underrated actors. I was trying to gauge the feelings on the YouTube trailer comments.
It's the right place to start it at, because I feel the power is always going to lie with the audience.
The audience, exactly.
Because they're the ones who are going to watch the content, they're the ones who are going to buy that ticket. Now, the thing is, like, on a social media platform, and if more and more films come there, the success of a film will truly be judged by the merit of the film, of how good or bad the film is. It'll not be so much of how much money did this film make, you know. And hence, the business of that platform now, to say, will depend on saying that, okay, I want to make content. This actor does good work. Let me work with this one. And eventually there'll be stars made out of this as well, because films also started like that. This is the only profession which I think is actually made out of dreams, because we are all in pursuit of making something that we've all imagined. We've all imagined of being Shiva who breaks that cycle chain, or even, you know, Aamir Khan and Jojita Vai Sikandar. So we're all kind of following that. We don't know how it's going to turn up. And all of us work towards that. And every star is made a star on the basis of a good film, or many good films. Doesn't just become a star overnight. So similarly, the web platform, the OTT platform, will have its stars. I mean, in the West, there are shows like Breaking Bad and The Office and all of, which have given so many stars to the world that have become movie stars based on something that they did, which was made for television or for an OTT platform. So yes, it is an interesting time to have this talk, to debate in a healthy way, like I said, and try to make sure that it is kept alive so that we keep pinching that other person if he's trying to go off track. But the support will always come from the audiences, because it all means nothing if those kind of films still keep doing what they're doing, or if the followers, I mean, you know, in the social media start following the people that are being sold to them so heavily. So, yeah, that's where the change needs to happen.
You know, I always feel that the audience, you know, the audience accepting you or audience watching you is kind of the last mile, you know. But there is a lot that goes in before that, whether it's, you know, whether it's getting in the theatrical system, getting your films seen by the audience, which is a huge struggle for most people, or getting media space, you know, in the press and the likes. And it's very difficult for, like you are bringing up, you know, more independent or underrated actors. It's very difficult for actors to be able to access these networks. Mm-hmm. And meanwhile, there is a privileged club which has it very easy in these areas, whether it's distribution or it's media. So again, like I said, I don't think there's going to be any major difference. I mean, you know, no matter what the YouTube comment section says, there will be a marginal difference, but that will be thanks to, like I said, streaming platforms in where distribution is concerned, and social media where media space is concerned.
Sure. I'm being told to wrap, but before I let you guys go, I also want to know, you know, the one thing that when I was sent the lineup of who I'd get to interview for Loot Case, the first thought that came to my mind was, wow, they are all good actors. So each one of y'all have consistently proved yourself as good actors. So I just want to understand, what are the challenges of being a good actor who isn't a star yet? Like, what are those challenges for y'all?
I don't know. I'm already a star, so I can't answer this.
Okay, you're excused. Sorry.
I think sometimes it feels like being a big dog stuck in a small dog's body. It's like, you know, when they say you have a Doberman pincher, which is the smaller size of a Doberman, big Doberman, and he's more aggressive because he's got so much energy and so much things to do. So you do feel like that at times. And I personally have always, like, for the last at least 6-7 years, every time I'm, you know, promoting a film, this has been a question has always asked me, like, you're an underrated actor, do you feel like you've got your due? And most of the times I don't know how to answer that question, because I'm like, I don't know what to say, because I always get that,
trust me, Kunal, I have been there. Just follow what I'm doing. Just say, dekh, main to star hu, main kuch bol nahi sakta, to tum dusre ko puchho. Because this is how it works, this is how you are, you know what I mean, this is how the approval comes from media, from the big films. You don't need that.
I am just saying, I have always taken things in a positive way. I mean, there are times where you just sit there and say, I don't know what to do. But I still feel that, okay, if I'm still as an underdog, I have a lot more to cover and a lot more to do. At least I'm not in a place where I've achieved everything and mega stardom and I have to worry about how to maintain it and worry about losing it. So it's nice. I mean, I see that carrot and I'm running towards it and I'm doing the best that I can.
I'm very curious what Gajju has to say about this.
मेरे लिए तो ये important है कि रणबीर जैसे स्टार के साथ मैं ये Zoom से कर रहा
हूँ। But गजराज सर, आप मेरे से बड़े स्टार हैं, आपको अंदाजा नहीं है।
मुझे बुरा अंदाजा है, मुझे मत चने की झाड़ पर चढ़ाओ, मैं तुम्हारा फैन हूँ जब तुम और विनय
आप मेरे से बड़े स्टार हैं आप, आपको आप हम्बल आप ज्यादा हम्बल हो रहे हैं, ज्यादा हम्बल मत होइए।
नॉट भैया, बहुत क्लैरिटी है दोस्त मेरे तो मेरे लिए बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है कि कुणाल जिनको मैं ये बचपन में ही स्टार हो गया था ये
एग्जैक्टली चाइल्ड स्टार से हो चाइल्ड स्टार से स्टार है वो
चाइल्ड स्टार से हाँ नहीं और कई कितने मतलब सैकड़ों एग्जाम में इनके इनके बेचे हुए पेन लेके मैंने सोचा कि पढ़ाई में पास हो जाऊंगा मैं
और रसिका तो एनीवे अब जैसे अब पवित्र पार्टी जिसने देख लिया वो ऑलरेडी स्टार हो चुकी खत्म हो गई काम Vote for her Pavitra party.
On that wonderful note, it's time to wrap up and I'm going to leave you by asking you guys, if you do find that suitcase full of money, what are you going to do? Are you going to take it or are you going to let it go?
मुझे अगर मिलेगा तो मैं विधु जी को हायर करूंगा एक फिल्म बनाने के लिए मेरा बड़ा मन है उनके साथ काम करने का
not a bad idea at all
so you're taking it, what about the rest of you?
I'll go to the police station and say, please find out किस गरीब का सूटकेस है, उसको बेचारे को तकलीफ हो रही होगी।
Having to run away from it and regret it and then run back.
I already have it, so I can't tell you what I'm going to do with this.
I am going to ask him. I literally have the suitcase, but it doesn't have the money inside it. They've all taken it out and given me the suitcase now.
That's very wink, wink, nudge, nudge, very loaded statement, Kunal.
Wonderful, Kunal. Kya baat hai?
Thank you guys so much. If this camaraderie translates on screen, we know we have a great film to watch. Thank you so much for providing much needed entertainment in lockdown. You've made it so much more bearable for the rest of us.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sneha. Thank you so much.